In the year 1893, the Spanish Franciscans, led by Father Peter Baptista, come to Japan to preach the gospel of Christ. Peter is royally entertained. He tells Hideyoshi, the military governor, about the great law of Christ. It is that men should love one another. Hideyoshi, who had fought many feudal wars, betraying and killing, regards this as a strange new doctrine. In the ancient capital of Kyoto, the cherry blossoms are in full bloom, and it is here that Father Baptista begins to preach. Brethren, we come to you from afar to tell you about the Christian way of life. God the Father made all men to be brothers. He sent his Son, Jesus Christ, to be our brother, and this Jesus loved us so much that he died willingly on a cross for the good of us all. His gentle words are met with violence on the part of some. But others take a more kindly view. Even Buddhist priests are impressed by Father Peter's meekness and humility. Besides preaching, the Franciscans help in many practical ways, such as providing food for the poor. And in accordance with the ritual of Japanese worship, Hideyoshi also offers food in thanksgiving. He is escorted to the temple by a magnificent entourage. Hideyoshi is well acquainted with the good work Father Peter has been doing. Now, as he returns from the temple, he stops and greets the Franciscan. In the most charming manner, he says, "You work always for my people, but you do nothing for yourself. What can I do for you?" Your Highness, would you allow us to build a temple to the God we serve? And Hideyoshi not only gives Ibushin, October 4th, 1594 is a glorious day, the dedication of the first Christian church in Kyoto. Jacqueline, an ambitious Buddhist priest, resents the intrusion of the Christians. The Japanese flock to mass. The women gather on the epistle side and the men on the gospel side. This custom still continues among Catholics in Japan. Father Peter Baptista kept careful records of the missionary work. This tells about a robber who threatened his life.
You don't have to steal, my son. May God give you strength to live an honest life.
Jack Queen, realizing that his influence with Hideyoshi is being destroyed, conspires against Father Peter and his followers. The plan is to start a rumor that Father Peter is a Spanish spy, that he had come to conquer Japan without bloodshed. It would spread a rumor that after the people had become Christians, Spain would send its fleet to Japan and rule the nation. In 1596, a great disaster falls upon Kyoto. A large meteor striking nearby is followed by volcanic eruptions and earthquakes. the Franskins and the Japanese when rescued. Thousands died and thousands were injured. The church is turned into a hospital to care for them. Among the mortally injured is the robber, who says, I have done much evil, but I have tried to make up for it, and yet I am afraid to die.
Don't be afraid, my son. Tell God you're sorry for all your evil deeds. Believe that Christ died for you and all sinners, and that he wants you to live with him in heaven.
Robert believed. Father Peter baptized him, and he died in peace. Little Lewis and his mother were Christians. He cried, Don't leave me, Mother. Let me go with you. After Father Peter administered the last sacraments to her, he assures the boy that God still has work for him to do. Is not one to overlook an opportunity. He tells Hideyoshi that the earthquake was a punishment from the gods for allowing the Christians to spread their teachings. He says that Father Baptista is a spy working for Spain. Hideyoshi is not convinced. He says, this is not the first time we've had an earthquake. Father Peter Baptista and his party show compassion for our people and attend their sufferings. Good deeds do not come from an evil heart. You are wicked priests. Get out of my sight. Ten weeks after the earthquake, a Spanish trading ship, the San Felipe, bound from the Philippines to Spain, is blown by a typhoon on the shore of Japan. On board are 100 soldiers and 7 missioners, and also cannon for use against pirates. The Spaniards demand permission to put back to sea. But the Japanese governor insists upon holding the guns and soldiers until he tried whether the ship had intended to attack Japan. The angry captain shouts, "If you seize our soldiers and guns, remember this. Spain has conquered all these countries. Japan is a small island, and Spain could subdue you with ease." Now, at last, Jack Queen and his fellow conspirators have a better case. Artfully, they tell Hideyoshi how the Spanish captain had threatened war, that it was all part of the same pattern. The missioners and the soldiers are finally coming together. What enrages Hideyoshi most is calling Japan a small country, one that could easily be crushed. And Hideyoshi says, "You were right, Jack Queen. Now that Father Peter Baptista is part of a clever plan to make a raid upon our country." arrest Father Baptista and his followers. I condemn them to death. Japanese authorities are determined to make an example of Father Peter Baptista and his close followers. They came from all walks of life, rich and poor, old and young. The officials ask one question: have you spread Christianity? To answer yes means one by one, they acknowledge their complete willingness to die for Christ. There was Yamano, a samurai or Japanese knight. There was little Louis, who had become a devout follower of Father Peter Baptista. Anthony, the 13-year-old son of a rich Chinese father and a Japanese mother. All freely offer to shed their blood for Christ. At Osaka, there was a Jesuit, Paul Mickey, age 33, and two Jesuit brothers. There were Michael Kozaki, an arrow maker, and his son, Thomas. They bid goodbye to wife and mother, prepared to die for their faith. Blessed are they who suffer persecution for the sake of justice, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. There were now 24 willing victims, 24 candidates for martyrdom, 6 Spanish Franciscan fathers and brothers, 3 Japanese Jesuit brothers, and 15 laypersons, including some altar boys. One of the punishments was to cut the lobe of the left ear. This is the first blood in Japan to be shed in the name of Christ. Let us ask God to strengthen our faith. Oh, what happiness it is that I can die at the same age that Christ was when he offered himself on the cross. On January 3rd, 1597, the 24 begin the death march of 500 miles to Nagasaki for execution. The purpose of the long journey is a warning that anyone who spreads Christianity would be punished by death as an enemy of Japan. Peter Baptista blesses the faithful along the way. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. In prison at Nishinomiya, Thomas Kozaki wrote his mother a letter. This very letter is now in the Vatican at Rome. To my honored and beloved mother, it is with the greatest love and respect that I send this letter to you. By this time, you will have heard that Father and I and the other followers of Father Baptista are to be crucified at Nagasaki. The edict of our execution has been published throughout the kingdom. Farewell, my dearest mother. I thank you for all the goodness you have shown me since God gave me to you. Father and I are going to heaven hand in hand, and there we shall wait for you. Your loving son, Thomas. When Pope Pius IX canonized little Thomas and the other 25 martyrs in 1862, he wept when he read this letter. First, the long and bitter journey to Nagasaki was by ox cart and on horseback, but mostly they were driven mercilessly as they marched on foot. And now the 25th martyr joins the holy group. He is Denkichi, a carpenter from Kyoto. The last to join is Petro, a well-to-do merchant who prizes his faith above his earthly wealth. Their number was now complete. There were 26 martyrs in all. Buddhist priest is deeply affected. I thank you from the bottom of my heart, but compared to the sufferings of the one whom I regard as the Son of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, this suffering is nothing. I'll remember your kindness in heaven. The final stage of the long journey was made by boat, They land on the shores of Tokitsu near Nagasaki on the early morning of the 5th of February in the year 1597, the unforgettable date of their martyrdom. The executioner in charge gives the laymen in the group a last chance to go free if they give up Christianity. There were 26 who marched and 26 who maintained their willingness to die out of love for him who also died on a cross for them. The executioner makes a last effort to influence the children. He offers to adopt them as his own and make them famous. But he cannot dim the light of faith in the hearts of these Christians. On a hill called Tatayama, a hill in the city of Nagasaki, the execution sentence is read. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Among those who came on this last day was a mother, the mother of young Anthony. She called to him, and he heard her, and he said, "Don't cry, my dearest mother, but rejoice. I shall ask God to bless you and bring you soon to heaven." God bless those who are about to kill us. May the blood we shed win the blessing of God for this country. My soul to thee. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, we give you our hearts and our souls. There is no other way to salvation but the way of God.